Chewy.
Aaliyah.
Yes.
Adhav.
Brandon.
Lindsay.
Kelly.
Cam.
Sandeep.
Lisa.
Rebecca.
Your name.
I do. Players, will you please scatter yourselves about the stage in a random little mishmash? That looks good. Freeze. Players, your arms from your elbow to your hand are deadly weapons. Here we are going to be playing a slow motion sword fight. When I say go.
Max wins.
That can also be a deadly weapon.
Sure.
Most terrifying of all. When I say go, these players are going to engage in a slow motion sword fight using their hands, now refashioned into deadly implements of war. They will not move fast, they will move about this speed. They will go slowly. And if they are touched by an enemy's sword, they will collapse dead to the ground. At the end, there will be one final winner who will receive a single extra bonus point. Our slow motion sword fight shall commence in 3, 2, 1, go!
Birds to be the most beautiful creatures on the earth. I've written lots of poems about birds.
Can we get
in the word.
Hey, my name is Sam. She calls me Sandeep. So these are my glasses, and actually I'm not a real bird watcher, but my mom caught me with these glasses when I was in high school, and I was like looking outside my window, and then she said, "Oh, are you into bird watching?" I said, "Yeah, that's what I do." And ever since that, I've had to keep up the charade. And I hold these glasses, and each time I'm at the window, my parents always say, "That's my son. He's a bird watcher."
Oh, fly, birdie, fly. Hello, everybody. My name is Snow White. I started the club. Oh, look at all these lovely folks in my garden. If only I weren't trapped.
Children's book. Audience, what could be the title of a children's book that has never been written? What was that?
Take a Jump.
Take a Jump? This is the book entitled Take a Jump. As player number one writes the story, we will see the other players act it out in front of us. And player number one is, of course, free to mess with it by undoing parts of the story, backspacing over it, and rewriting parts of it. When the lights come up, the wonderful children's book, Take a Jump.
Woo! Woo!
Take a jump, take a jump, take a jump.
Jack and John were the best of friends, and they lived together on the tallest mountain. They were goat brothers. No. They were ostrich brothers. I like goat brothers better. Yeah, they were goat brothers. They were living together on the top of a mountain.
That's the sound goats make.
The sound that goats make is
John! We've been living on this mountain our entire lives. You're my best friend, and I don't want that to change ever. But what about when we grow up and graduate school? Goat school.
I don't know. Maybe somewhere else.
John had a wonderful idea. After they graduate goat school, they would jump off the mountain and live in the town below with all the other goats that weren't stuck on top of the mountain. But really, they were lonely. They just wanted to live with the rest, so they looked over the edge of the mountain and thought, should we jump?
Should we jump?
No.
Jump!
What's that?
Jump!
It's fun down here!
What?
We're partying!
Jack did a little hop to test his jumping skills. He jumped even higher to test his jumping skills and did a little dance at the end.
Come on, John, let's do that together right now. We're friends, so hey, jump, and then a little kick out. Yeah.
They were the best dancers on the top of the mountain, but would it hold up at the bottom of the mountain? They weren't sure. They looked over the edge and thought,
we're really good at dancing down here.
Oh, looks like they're really good at dancing down there. Look at that ostrich.
Dancing.
He's not keeping his head in the sand. Isn't that right, John?
Yeah.
Jack said, look at me, I can dance better than that ostrich. I can dance ostrich style. Watch.
Look at me, I can dance better than an ostrich. I can dance ostrich style.
We'll never know, but was that wonderful children's story a one, a two, a three, a four, a five? Woo! That's even a three. Play your score yourself.
I can get the remaining four players, please. Excellent. Players 9 and 8, you two will be in a scene.
Okay.
And then players 6 and 5, you will tag them out of that scene when I say freeze. And then you'll tag each other back and forth in parallel universe.
Oh, okay.
Now, what's the location two people might hang out?
The beach.
The beach, okay. So you'll be at the beach. And what's the farthest thing imaginable from the beach?
A unicorn.
You are in a magical unicorn, My Little Pony cloud situation.
What's that like?
You're on the beach when the lights come up.
This is the life, Mortimer. Oh my god, I'm so glad we're not at the office right now. We're skipping the day, right? Right?
Yeah!
Yes!
Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. Sparkles.
Jurassica.
Amazing. Doesn't it feel so soft up here?
It does. I can comb through and see right down to the ground. We're so high up.
These clouds are pink.
Like rainbow unicorn candy. I could just eat it all.
Oh, should we grab some?
I freeze.
I'm gonna kiss this shark. I don't care what you say. I'm gonna do it. Oh, you gotta wait. We're high up, but the altitude, it makes it cold. That's science.
I didn't know about science. Oh, is that like when you brush your teeth?
Can I get a day from player 5? Can you day for me?
Nay! Let's go back to the teeth thing. How did you lose both of them?
I'm not really sure.
I mean,
one of them just flew away, I guess.
Worst advice.
Excellent. And can I have player Chewy say?
Let's go up.
Well, you know it's great when I put you in checkmate. That's a date. Checkmate.
Probably just when my grandpa like takes my king out. It happens like every game. Drives me nuts.
How about you, sir?
You go right in front of the queen with your king. Bishop.
those pesky bishops, they can always just get in your way. I always try to take them out first. Can we get one last question from the audience? Yes, you.
What's the best way to win?
What is the best way to win? We all need to know that.
So we asked the other players to go get coffee for them.
Alright, blatant cheating. That is good. What about you?
Kind of hoping that I'd come on the show and I'd learn that. But frankly, don't have an answer for that.
Why'd you say you're an expert in your email? Okay, how about you?
The best way to win is not to play at all.
That song is a checkmate. What was that scene? A one? A two? A three? A four? A five? I think it was a four. Players, score yourself.
Can I get two players, please, Nick?
Absolutely. You may get player number 12 and player number 3.
Excellent. I need a little help from the audience. We'll promise we'll take really good care of you. Do we have any volunteers? Yeah,
come on. Woohoo!
And yes, sir.
Who are you talking to here?
You.
All me?
Yes.
Okay.
Are you okay with your shoulders being touched? Okay, cool. So they're going to come and they're going to touch you on the shoulder and you say any word that you want. And if you can't think of a word to say, just say sandwich. What's wrong with you?
Salad.
Great. What's a location that you might meet a friend? Yeah, go ahead.
At the park.
At the park. You guys are at the park when the lights come up. Woo!
Audience, could we get a normal, everyday activity that two people might be doing? Yes?
They could be walking their dogs.
Walking their dogs, yes. You two are walking your dogs, and occasionally you will need to call in the help of a stunt double when the lights come up.
Oh, Cheryl, I'm so glad you came with me today. I'm so glad you're willing to walk all seven of them. You're doing great.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. Just tell him to heal. Heal.
Oh,
maybe I could pay you back with some like sweet entertainment.
Yeah, can I get a bunch of dogs
up on the stage?
Yeah. Oh my gosh! Oh my goodness! Oh, I'm having a litter right now. Oh my god!
Thank you.
Can I push you on the swing? This is like my favorite game. It makes me feel so strong. Yeah.
Alrighty there. What's going on in this big round? Look like you were pushing a little high there, T-Rex.
High as I can go.
And you, Pterodactyl, I know you're used to being high, but this swing's only supposed to go so far.
Well, I can go farther.
Quit your bragging. you two come here every week, and every week you cause your trouble with your Jurassic ways. What do you have to say for yourself?
So it's not built for T-Rexes. We need a bigger playground. We won't break the swing so much.
We've been talking about making this more inclusive. So look what I got behind this curtain.
Whoosh!
It's a short arm slide.
That slide I can go on with my short arms.
That's right.
Yeah. Wow, that was so much better than the normal slides. The requires my use of my arms.
Well, we like to please here at the playground.
Love it. Can you make a swing that goes higher than he can fly?
Ah, can I? Sure. Here you go. There's a big old swing for you to fly straight up to the sky, but you gotta use your wings to use it?
Something
with
flying.
Got it. Get on your swing, fly up high. Don't be scared of the big blue sky. You're gonna swing and have a good time, and you're gonna slide all the time. And when it's a playground time for the dinosaurs, and I like y'all to be nice to each other. Oh, come on back down. Come on back down. Now, are we having a good time now?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'll be nice to you if you stop making fun of my arms.
That's really not nice.
And I'll stop making fun of you flying away.
All right. But occasionally, there will be music in the background. Can we get a sample of some music? And when that happens, you look directly in each other's eyes. A long gaze.
Stop playing.
And when the music stops, you have to look away. When the music is playing, you must look in each other's eyes. When the music is not playing, you must not. Audience, can I get a suggestion for a relationship between two people? Yes.
Best friends.
Yeah? Best friends. Oh. Yeah, you are best friends. What are these best friends doing? Where have they gone to hang out for today? Yeah.
An amusement park.
An amusement park. You are best friends at an amusement park. Musical eye contact. When the lights come up. Yes!
Yes, Jerry! What ride is next? I'm amped!
I want to go. I don't know what it's called. I can't read that well. You know, I'm still in third grade. What's that called?
It's okay that you can't read it, Marty.
I know, you understand.
There's still time to develop that skill.
That's what I'm talking about.
But if we squint close, I think it says the bullet train.
The bullet train!
The bullet train!
Yes! Let's do it!
I can't... wait to ride it with you.
I just want to go like two bullets.
We'll be so fast. Oh my gosh, but that line.
Oh my gosh.
I think there's
a line for us kids where we can just, you know, sneak in and go through. What do you think?
My daddy got a fast pass.
You got a fast pass?
Yes!
Do I have a fast pass?
Yeah,
this is fast.
I sure hope you do.
Okay. So,
I really
so let's
go
do one
on.
Thing.
Yeah, what's that?
After we... What are these jokers mean? Look at us, Kyle.
Oh, sir. They're here to stop our fun.
Why?
We can't let them.
Did Jimmy send them?
That bad Jimmy.
Jimmy!
He's a bad man.
We'll never make him best friend and we'll never play tag with him from today.
I'm not running away to the circus with Jimmy.
Look! I think this is Jimmy.
Oh, Jimmy's here. Jimmy!
Why did you come here?
This was our day of fun.
I just wanted to have fun with you.
Oh! But then...
That's so sweet of him.
But he never gave me the plastic tattoo that he has when I asked him. I wanted that bunny tattoo so
The
bad.
Temporary one that washes off?
Yeah. I wanted that so bad.
Was that amusement park scene? A one, a two, a three, a four, a five.
I've heard lots of rumble.
No, no, my lord. No, no. We are all very happy to live under your rule.
Ho, ho, ho! Oh, I just wish it was Christmas. I would love to say that one day. And why do we only get one day a year? You should expand Christmas.
Silence!
I think you should tell him something. I think I should say something right now.
Hold it!
Just say it to him! Just say it to him!
Yes!
Activity that is not in any way British.
Drinking tea.
Not British.
Hot dog eating contest.
You're at a hot dog eating contest. And periodically throughout this scene, you're going to start off as very normal characters who are not British at all. But every time that I ding this bell, you're going to get slightly more British. And by the end of it, you're going to be extremely British. So a game of more British and a hot dog eating contest where the lights come up.
Woohoo! You're going down, man.
Oh. Janice, good to see you again. I just do this for fun.
I'm not going up this time.
No.
I'm going to win. I'm going to win that new Cadillac.
Okay. More British.
I'm going to win that new Cadillac.
I say, there's a new Cadillac on the line for this competition.
Yeah, but we must not dilly-dally.
let me grab my cup of tea and water up my gullet.
I'm afraid the contest has been changed. You're eating bangers and mash instead.
Bangers and mash?
Yes, no hot dogs.
Oh! Gas!
More British?
Why, I didn't prepare for this!
Crackerjack!
Crumpets!
Fiddlesticks!
How are we going to drive that Cadillac on the wrong side of the road?
I don't know!
We take it back to England with us!
Oh,
dreadful indeed. Well, okay, let me grab my napkin.
More French.
And, my escargot!
Once again!
Make my gullet nice and sleek!
Baguette! Baguette!
Merci beaucoup! Oui, oui!
More French!
A glass of wine with our baguette! I'm
the finest of the fine red wine.
Only
more Italian.
Ah, mamma mia.
Good job, players. Was that a trip throughout all of Europe? A one, a two, a three, a four, a five. Player number 11 and player number 7.
Great. Player number 3, can you sit in the chair?
Oh, okay.
Player 11, can you sit here? Player 7, can you sit here?
can I get, actually, yeah, that's fine. Can I get a volunteer from the audience? Would you like to volunteer? Okay, come on up. But you are one person, and you will be saying one word at a time. For example, if I said hello, what's your name?
I am
Doctor.
Excellent. And what job are they interviewing for?
Toilet cleaning.
You're interviewing for a toilet cleaning job. When the lights come up.
Hello, Mr. Clean here. On today's interview, we are going to see who the best toilet cleaner is, and we have a very good toilet cleaner here. Could you please introduce yourself, best toilet cleaner?
I am
the
great Mr.
Bunsen.
Wow, Mr. Gunson. Now, your resume is quite impressive. Could you just tell me some of your experience?
I have
made
of the
other
discoveries.
Very interesting. Go on. Discoveries of toilet cleaning. I didn't know you were a scientist as well as an expert cleaner. Where did you get your education?
We
Harvard.
Secret parrot. Woo! Ow! Woo!
Your dog got married to a Yorkie the other day?
Yeah. Yeah, he did. That was really cute. Yeah. Best friends with their owner, too.
Oh, they're really going to be best friends with their owner?
Yeah, see? Look.
Oh.
Yeah. We have some more dogs. Can some of the dogs come back?
Can we have some more dogs? Can some of the dogs come back? Thank you for showing me all of these other dogs.
I gotta feed them their sausages.
They're gonna need money too. I know these dogs. They like to hang out with my little dog here.
Yeah, I feel kind of ruffled.
Hey, here's some crackers, you silly. Crackers? Oh yes.
I have a feeling you're not telling me something.
I couldn't possibly imagine what that would be.
You're acting really cagey.
Well, it's been a long time since I've been out of the house.
Why are the dogs following your every move? They want to, like, I smell jumping.
Maybe they're just a fan of brightly colored people?
Yeah.
Yes, I'm a person.
Where are you making duck noises?
Once again, all the dogs get an automatic five. That was so good. It feels scripted, but it's improv, so you know they were just playing it. That scene, a one, a two, a three, a four, a five. That scene was a five, score yourself.
Thank you.
Very good.